just got redder and redder and surer, and when you see a small baby scratching themselves to the point that they're bleeding, you just think you need some help. He was 4 months old when we first discovered that he had eczema. His skin condition had developed. Having spoken to the doctors and getting him tested for any lactose intolerance, it was nothing to do with that. It was just that he had eczema. So we were in no man's land. We didn't know what to do. We didn't know how to deal with this. And it was a friend that actually recommended getting in touch with Eczema Outreach support, as she'd been through the same thing with her wee boy. And the support we received was fantastic. They gave us advice on the creams that we did have, trying to make the most of them. They gave us advice on how to apply the creams, which we didn't know. Until you see a dermatologist, you don't know any of these things. So to have a team on hand, Eczema Outreach support, to be able to give you this information was priceless, really. We're really grateful for the support we had. The cream's done. Between 4 and 5 times a day, which when you want to get everyone ready and at least maybe try and get yourself to the park for 2 minutes, it makes it quite difficult. You have to stick to quite a difficult regime. We're going to go to the park later, darling, okay? A long day like that, I would come back to either a voicemail or an email or a text message from the guys at Eczema Outreach Support. And for me, that was the best thing to have, because at the end of the day, when you're so fed up and you've given all you can to try and help his skin get better, to try and keep the house afloat, and just to try and keep sane, to have someone there who understands, that was really helpful. We're very lucky that a year on, Rudy's skin is cleared. And he still gets these creams done twice a day, and he does have flare-ups, but we know how to manage them now. Hello. Stop. You say hi, yeah?